The story of Julius Nyerere, first president of Tanzania. Hello, Displorers. Welcome to another interesting video presented to you by The Splorer, and thanks for watching. African leaders are known for their power-hungry attitudes, grabbing onto it till death do them part. But here is a man who fought not for his own good, but for that of his fellow countrymen, gracefully grooming and handing over the ranks of power, in due time, to become one of the most respected African leaders, father, and teacher. His true nature can be seen in small matters, such as turning down a well-paying job many times for the one which he knows can be of service better for, as well as cutting his own salary to lead the nation to better good. This is contrary to the embezzlement characters roaming the African continent in the name of president today, looking for every single coin to fill their pockets with. Hence, in this video, we shall tell the heartwarming story of a patriotic man and the first president of Tanzania, Julius Nyerere. If you're new here, welcome. Be sure to subscribe and turn on notifications so you don't miss any of our videos. Julius Kambarage Nyerere, born 13th April 1922 in Mwitongo, in Tanganyika's Mara region, was one of 25 surviving children of Nyerere Burito, the chief of the Zanaki people. As the son of a chief, he was exposed to African-administered power and authority, and living in the compound gave him an appreciation for communal living, and that would influence his later political ideas. Nyerere began his education at the Native Administration School in Musenge, Musoma, in February 1934, about 35 kilometers from his home. Nyerere excelled at school, skipped a grade, and by 1936, his elementary schooling ended, with his final exam results being the highest of any pupil in the Lake Province and Western Province region. His academic excellence allowed him to gain a government scholarship to attend the elite Tabora Government School. He was heavily involved in the school's debating society. Teachers recommended him as head prefect, but this was vetoed by the headmaster, who described Nyerere as being too kind for the position. In March 1942, during Nyerere's final year at Tabora, his father died and Nyerere decided to be baptized as a Roman Catholic, taking the name Julius. In October 1941, Nyerere completed his secondary education and decided to study at Makerere College in the Ugandan city of Kampala, where he won a literary competition with an essay on the subjugation of women. In July 1943, he wrote a letter to Tanganyika Standard in which he discussed the ongoing World War II, arguing that capitalism was alien to Africa and that the continent should turn to African socialism as the African is by nature a socialistic being. The letter serves to mark the beginnings of Nyerere's political maturation. In 1943, Nyerere, Andrew Tibandebaj, and Hamza Kibwana Bakari founded the Tanganyika African Welfare Association, TAWA, later replaced by the Tanganyika African Association, TA. Although aware of racial prejudice from the white colonial minority, he insisted on treating people as individuals, recognizing that many white individuals were not prejudiced towards indigenous Africans. After 3 years, Nyerere graduated from Makerere with a diploma in education. Early teaching. On leaving Makerere, Nyerere returned home to Zanaki, built a house for his widowed mother, and was offered teaching positions at both the state-run Tabora Boys' School and the mission-run St. Mary's, but chose the latter despite it offering a lower wage. He took part in public debate with two teachers from the Tabora Boys' School, in which he argued against the statement that the African has benefited more than the European since the partition of Africa. Outside school hours, he gave free lessons in English to older locals and also gave talks on political issues. He also worked briefly as a price inspector for the government, but quit the position after the authorities ignored his reports about false pricing. In Tabora, he started courting Maria Gabriel, a teacher of Nyengeni Primary School in Musoma, proposed marriage to her, and they became informally engaged at Christmas in 1948. At St. Mary's, Father Richard Walsh, an Irish priest who was director of the school, encouraged Nyerere to consider additional education in the UK, which he did. In April 1949, Nyerere went to Edinburgh, where Nyerere took further his education. In 1949, Nyerere was one of the only two black students from the British East African territories studying in Scotland and graduated in July 1952 with a degree of Master of Arts. Political activism. After returning home from his studies in Zanikiland, he built a mud brick house for himself and his fiancée, Maria, whom he married on 24th of January 1953. They moved to Pugu, where Nyerere was hired to teach history at St. Francis College, and in 1953, the couple had their first child, Andrew. Nyerere became increasingly involved in politics. In April 1953, he was elected president of the Tanganyika African Association. On 7 July 1954, Nyerere, assisted by Oscar Kambona, transferred the TA into a new political party, the Tanganyika African National Union, TANU. Nyerere insisted on the need for Tanganyikan independence, but maintained that the country's European and Asian minorities would not be ejected by an African-led independent government. The colonial government closely monitored his activities, as they had concerns that Nyerere would instigate a violent anti-colonial rebellion, similar to the Mau Mau uprising in neighboring Kenya. In August 1954, the United Nations had sent a mission to Tanganyika, which subsequently published a report recommending a 20 to 25 year timetable for the colony's independence, which Nyerere rejected. The government pressured Nyerere's employer to sack him, but Nyerere resigned from the school, in part because he did not wish his ongoing employment to cause trouble for the missionaries. In April 1955, he and his wife returned to his Zanaki home state. He turned down offers of employment from a newspaper and an oil company, instead accepting a job as a translator and tutor for the Marinol Fathers, who were preparing a mission amongst the Zanaki. The British colonial governor of Tanganyika, Edward Twining, disliked Nyerere, hence established the Multiracial United Tanganyika Party, UTP, to combat TANU's African nationalist message. Nyerere nevertheless stipulated that, "We are fighting against colonialism, not against the whites." Twining even organized unfair elections, which were unfair to the 98% indigenous majority. At the January 1958 conference in Tabora, Nyerere convinced TANU to take part, and TANU won every seat it contested. TANU in government, 1959-1961. In 1960, Nyerere attended the Conference of Independent African States in Addis Ababa, Ethiopia, where he presented a paper calling for the formation of an East African Federation. He suggested that Tanganyika could delay its attainment of independence from the British Empire until neighboring Kenya and Uganda were able to do the same, which will make it easier, but many senior TANU members opposed. In May, Tanganyika achieved self-governance, and Nyerere's first act as Prime Minister was to stop the supply of Tanganyikan labourers to South African gold mines as protest against the apartheid system in South Africa. Premiership and Presidency of Tanganyika. In February 1962, the government announced its desire to convert the pervasive system of freehold land ownership into a leasehold system, an idea Nyerere praised in an article he wrote called Ujama or Familyhood. On 9 December 1962, Tanganyika became a republic. The early years of Nyerere's presidency were preoccupied largely by African affairs, as he endorsed the Pan-Africanist idea of unifying Africa, although he disagreed with the Ghanaian president Kwame Nkrumah's view that this could be achieved quickly. Pursuing these ideals, in June 1963, Nyerere and some African presidents agreed to unite their respective countries into a single East African Federation by the end of the year, which never materialized, and Nyerere saw his inability to establish an East African Federation as the biggest failure of his career. In January 1964, Nyerere ended affirmative action hiring for the civil service, which made many trade unionists denounce and it proved the catalyst for an army mutiny. This took place in two phases, with Nyerere barely escaping to hide in the Roman Catholic mission for 2 days. On 22nd January, Nyerere came out of hiding and said that he would not call for military assistance from the UK. But 2 days later, he requested British military assistance, which was granted to subdue the mutineers. Nyerere attributed the mutiny to the fact that his government had failed to do enough to change the army since colonial times, and made changes which acknowledged some of the mutineers' demands. Presidency of Tanzania. Following the Zanzibari Revolution, Abeid Karume declared himself president of a one-party state. In April, he visited Karume. The following day, they announced the political unification of Tanganyika and Zanzibar. An interim constitution for the United Republic of Tanganyika and Zanzibar presented Nyerere as the country's president, with Karume as its first vice president, and the name of the country was changed to the United Republic of Tanzania. Karume was erratic, unpredictable, and a source of repeated embarrassment to Nyerere, who tolerated him for the sake of Tanzanian unity. But in April 1972, Karume was assassinated by 4 gunmen. With rapid increase in population, free education became hard to ensure for all. Hence, those who received it had to perform 2 years of service in the GKT, which university students protested. Nyerere spoke to the students in defense of the measure, agreed to reduce government salaries, including his own, and also moving out of the state house. In January 1967, Nyerere made the Arusha Declaration, whose main aim was to build a sustainable nation, and this led to the nationalization of several banks and companies in the country. By 1969, Nyerere was contemplating retirement from the presidency, and after the 1970s and 1980s elections, which he won in a landslide, Nyerere handed over to successor Ali Hassan Mwinyi in 1985. In doing so, Nyerere was one of the few African presidents to have voluntarily, gracefully and honorably bowed out of governance, which brought him much respect internationally. In August 1990, Nyerere stepped down as the chair of CCM, but before stepping down as CCM chair, he advocated Tanzania's transition into a multi-party democracy. In 1995, he gave the NUFA speech, in which he warned of cracks in the Tanzanian state, caused by corruption, separatism, tribalism, and concerns which were influenced by the recent event of the Rwandan genocide. By 1998, Nyerere was aware that he had terminal leukemia, but kept this from the public. In September of 1999, he traveled to England for medical care, being hospitalized in St. Thomas Hospital, London, where on the 14th of October 1999, he died, with his wife and 6 children at his bedside. Benjamin Mkapa, Tanzanian president at the time, announced Nyerere's death on national television and also proclaimed a 30-day mourning period. Legacy. Nyerere's ideology, a form of African socialism, is known as Ujamaa. For much of his life, he was a prolific writer and speaker, leaving much material behind, espousing his ideology. Nyerere was a great man of principle, and exhibited a great ability and talent to rationalize his political actions with an astute exposition of principles. Within Tanzania, Nyerere had been termed the father of the nation and was also known as Mwalimu or teacher. He gained recognition for the successful merger between Tanganyika and Zanzibar and for leaving Tanzania as a united and stable state. Nyerere was often depicted as Tanganyika's wonderkind, remembered as one of Africa's most respected statesmen and one of the world's most influential leaders of the 20th century. There you have it, explorers. That was the story of the first president of Tanzania, Julius Nyerere. Thanks for watching this video, and if you did enjoy this video, do all to give it a thumbs up, and do not forget to subscribe and share with your friends.